Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will start exploring how you can use the copy and paste feature of RoboDK to save a lot of time in your projects. Let's get started. So here's the station we created together. So with the robot, laser cutting head, parts and everything. So one thing that I would recommend you when you're working with RoboDK is to try to reuse as much as what you've created in the past. So this way you will always kind of be faster and faster because you won't always be starting from zero. So to be able to do that, you need to have to understand how the copy and paste feature works. If you want to simply copy a program, that's fairly easy. Control C program, so right, so Control C on your keyboard or edit, and then copy. Would recommend copy Control C most of the time. You select the station and then Control V, and then the program was created. There's not much more to it if you want to copy stuff from a station to the exact same station. But so there's a few things that I want to show you though. If you right click on the program, you will see there's an option here called robot, and our robot is here. So this is the robot that is linked to the specific program. So this is, I just want to bring your attention to that. And the same goes for a target. So if you right click a target, robot linked, and there's a robot here, which is the only robot we have. If we had more than one robot, obviously we would have a list here that we could select a robot from. And you can do that for multiple robots here, right click, robot link, and then we have the link here, or the robot link. So that's super important because this link will be lost if you copy and paste stuff from one station to another. So I'm gonna have to show you how to deal with that afterwards. Okay, so let's say that we want to copy, I'm gonna delete the cutting here, copy some stuff from this station to a new one to create the same thing. We have pretty much the same part and everything. There's just a few things different, let's say. So I'm gonna go Control N to create a new station. And let's say I will open this one and I want to copy the robot. So I'm gonna go Control C and then Control V. Nothing happens. And in fact, I pasted the cutting program I had previously on my clickboard. So that's weird. I'm gonna delete this one, double click here. I'm gonna copy, let's say the robot, select the new station, Control V, and it doesn't work. It only kind of dropped another robot in the station we already had. So all of that is very normal. If you want to copy and paste stuff from one station to the other, you need to double click the station you wanna copy stuff from. So you need to activate the source station. Then you need to Control C. Let's say Control C, I don't know, this part here. Then you need to double click the new station to activate it. And then you need to Control V. So you really need to double click on one and double click on the other. So now this one will be copy and paste. And here we'll rename this one source for the purpose of this example. So that's how you can copy stuff from one station to the other. You really need to activate the station you're copying from and activate the station you're copying to. Okay, next, let's say I want to copy everything in one blow. So I might be tempted to select the first one, press Shift, select here, Control C, double click the new one here, let's delete this here, and then Control V. That would work. But as you can see, we now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times the part for some reasons. We have 2 times the robot, 2 times the tool. We have a bunch of targets that are not attached to a frame or anything. So why is it like that? That's fairly simple. When you select a frame and you copy a frame, it will copy all the childs that are linked to it. So if you select everything, you're copying this one and everything inside of it, copying this one and everything inside of it, copying this one and everything inside of it. So you're kind of creating duplicates of everything. So if you want to copy that, the only thing you need to do is select the first one, Control C. So select the frame that is parent to everything. You come here, delete everything. So select the first one, press and hold Shift, select the last one, delete. And then I'm going to go Control V. And now I just copied the robot once and the targets once here. Okay. Now, as I told you before, there was that link with the robot. So here, as you can see, when we copied stuff from one station to the other, the link is lost. That's not a big deal, but just need to remember it. So we need to select the first tool, the first target, press and hold Shift, select the last target, right click, and then you have robot linked, and you can link the robot we have here to this one. And now all the targets are reachable. Just like that here. Perfect. You see here, there's one with that is recorded another configuration. If you don't remember why it's the case, go back to module one. I'm explaining why this occurs. And I'm also explaining why if you're using just linear motions, it won't. So that's the first thing. Then let's say if we want to copy the cutting programs. So let's copy those, Control C, and then here, paste. They are copied, they are there. But if you right click here, robot, you will see that no robot is linked. So I need to do that. Otherwise, it says if I double click, robot is undefined. So here, right click, and then robot link, FANUC here. Perfect. So I can do that for the other ones. So I can do it for multiple multiple programs at the same time, same as for the targets. If I run that here, it says target is undefined. This is because, unfortunately, for each target that was here, the link is also lost with this target here. Same for the tool. So we need to right click and link the different targets to the different motion to the different targets. It's generally way faster than starting from scratch. Remember the last time it took me over 2 minutes just to create, just to create the targets. Now within 2 minutes, my bad here. If I'm a bit more consistent. So now within 2 minutes, I'll have a working program just like that here. So even if it takes a bit of time, it's still faster than doing everything from scratch. I just have, especially in this case where the name are still the same, so I just need to redefine the name. So I need to do the same with the frame, part one and then part two. No need to do the same with the program call. This is really just linked to the name of the program call, so it doesn't matter if the link was lost. There was no link apart from the actual robot name or program name. And now I can run my main. And if I didn't do anything wrong, it will run in the new station. So that's important. So this way you can have, I don't know, palletizing or cutting or welding template, and you just bring everything in the new station and you just add the new part, something like that. So you can save a lot of time by just knowing how to deal with the few old quirks that comes with copy and paste. So, okay, that's everything for this video. In the next one, we will continue talking about copy paste, but this time regarding robot positions, XYZ Cartesians and orientation. So we can also copy and paste that around instead of having to transfer the six values one by one. So that's super useful. And we will conclude by changing, using the copy paste, but to change the default home position. So you can change the way RoboDK behave if you right click the robot and press home to another position instead of the one generic one. So we'll show you how to do that at the end of the next video. So I hope this one was helpful, and I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day, guys.